Hey guys, back with another video, and today we have my NFL Week 13 predictions video. How is it Week 13 already? I don't understand. It's almost December. It's about to be December soon, and time is just going by too fast here. Last week I ended up going 12-4, making my entire record on the season 121-59. So the record looking pretty good this year, honestly. And we have a lot of teams on bye, so let's just go right over it. You have the Ravens, the Bears, the Raiders, the Vikings, the Bills, and the Giants all on the bye this week. A lot of teams on the bye, so hopefully that means this video should be quicker because there's less games. See how that math works? Yeah, fun times. We get to the Thursday night game, and it will be the Seattle Seahawks taking on the Dallas Cowboys. This is actually the first team with a winning record that the Cowboys will be facing this season, as far as I know. But they're 6-5, you know, not looking too good. Taking the L on Thanksgiving last week to the Niners, and then the Cowboys obviously getting the win on Thanksgiving against their rival Commanders. And although, you know, the Seahawks have a winning record, although they do, they're just not a good team really at all. They've started to come back down to earth these past couple weeks, and I think the Cowboys will take advantage of that like they always do and beat up another bad team. So, give me the Cowboys. Getting to the Sunday games, starting with the Los Angeles Chargers taking on the New England Patriots. The Chargers taking a tough L on Sunday Night Football to the Ravens, and the Patriots, God, they suck. They really suck. Taking an L to the Giants, freaking miss a 30-yard chip shot to lose the game. Yeah, just, we really have lived to see the day where Bill Belichick and the New England Patriots are a poverty franchise. You love to see it. You really do, honestly. So since they're a poverty franchise now, I'm going to have them lose another game here, and I'm going to take the Los Angeles Chargers. The Chargers, they have not looked good these past couple weeks, but I think with a game like this early in the morning, I think no pressure on them, really. So I think I'm going to take the Chargers here, finally picking up a W in the win column. So give me the Chargers. Next up, you have the Detroit Lions taking on the New Orleans Saints. The Saints, they took a tough L to their rival Atlanta Falcons, losing that number one spot in the NFC South for now. Obviously, that could change quickly. And then the Lions, obviously, losing to my Green Bay Packers last week, but they're still 8-3. They're still at the top of the NFC, near the top at least, so yeah, I'm going to take the Lions here, getting a nice bounce-back win against the Saints. You have the Atlanta Falcons taking on the New York Jets. I don't know why I paused there, but that's besides the point. The Falcons getting the win over the Saints last week, like I said. And, the Falcons, The Jets, they really need to get something going. Aaron Rodgers is back in practice. How? I don't know. I really don't know. But he's not starting, obviously. It seems like it's going to be another week or two. But if the Jets keep losing, like, why even come back, Rodgers? Why even come back? You can't play 60% of the snaps anyways. Packers don't have a first-round pick next year. That's rough. And then the Falcons, like I said, getting the win last week over the Saints, taking that number one spot. So, you know, the Jets really need to win this one, but I'm going to say that the Falcons, they ruined that parade for the Jets, and they stomp all over it. So, give me the Falcons with, I mean, it's not an upset, but, like, this game could easily go either way, I think, but give me the Falcons. They're just more in a roll, I think. You got the Arizona Cardinals taking on the Pittsburgh Steelers. The Cardinals. Don't remember what they did last. Oh, yeah. They got beat up by the Los Angeles Rams. Just not good. Not good at all. And then the Steelers getting the win over the Bengals. Barely. I mean, it's whatever, you know? These Steelers fans are coming out. Oh, it wasn't Pickett's fault. It was Matt Canada's fault. Kenny Pickett for the Super Bowl. Kenny franchise. Blah, 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 blah. I don't buy into the Kenny Pickett train yet. I mean, I watched Kenny Pickett at Pitt, and he just, I don't know. He had cool highlights. It's kind of really the only reason I think he got drafted. He had cool highlights and a one-year wonder. I really didn't see a lot from him at Pitt. But, hey, if he goes on and wins a playoff game this year, I'll give him his flowers. I'll give him his props. But I think this is an easy win either way here for the Steelers. So, give me the Pittsburgh Steelers. You got the Indianapolis Colts taking on the Tennessee Titans. Titans. They got the win against the Panthers last week. Finally got a win. Needed a win. And then the Colts, I don't remember what they did last week. I know they didn't have a bye. Nobody had a bye last week. That was because of Thanksgiving, you know. They got the win over the Bucks. That's right. See, the Titans just have not looked good, you know. They have not looked good. They looked about as good as I thought they were going to look this year. Just not that good. I mean, it's tough with multiple quarterback switches. And the Colts, they've kind of found their good quarterback replacement this year in Gardner Minshew. That's my boy, WSU. And that offense, I said this in AC News, that offense should be looked at as a little bit scary, not gonna lie. I mean, Minshew, he's played well this year. Michael Pittman, that's my boy, he's played incredible this year. Jonathan Taylor, obviously being Jonathan Taylor. Josh Downs, rookie wide receiver out of UNC, he's played well too. And then Zach Moss, he's done incredible as far as fantasy goes, so. Yeah, I think I'm going to give this one to the Colts. I think they're just the better team right now compared to the Titans. And I'm going to have the Colts going up to 7-5. Taking them. You got the Miami Dolphins taking on the Washington Commanders. The Dolphins, they got the win on Black Friday last week. A weird game. But they got the win either way against the Jets. And then the Commanders, I don't remember what they did. Oh, yeah, they lost to the Cowboys. That's right. They sucked. Sam Howell did not look good really at all. See, Howell, he's led the league in passing yards, but he's also led the league in interceptions, as far as I know, especially after last week. I mean, Deron Bland just ruined his day. And I don't think he's going to have much of an easier time here against the Dolphins. Unless Ramsey, I'm pretty sure Ramsey's healthy. I think. I'm positive. So give me the Dolphins. I think they're just the way better team right now. Easy win. Next up, you got the Denver Broncos taking on the Houston Texans. The Broncos, 5-game winning streak. They were 1-5. Now they're 6-5. What? I don't understand it. Texans, they haven't looked too bad themselves. Last week, I don't remember. What'd they do? I don't remember, honestly. I'm going to keep it a book with you. I really don't. Let me check here. The Texans took the L. That's right. They played the Jags. Just barely took the L. Okay. Now, I'm friends with a couple Broncos fans, and they've been at my neck. They've been like, oh my god, Alex, the Broncos country, let's ride. I mean, because last year, it was clear that I was the biggest Broncos hater after they just became terrible. And going into the season, you could tell I was the biggest Broncos hater. I only had them winning like 5 games this year. They have 6 wins now. I've seen a lot more from the Texans this year, which something I never thought I'd say. CJ Stroud, Tank Dell, that offense has looked like firepower this year. It's unreal how well they've played. And I think they're going to continue that here and get a bounce back win because, you know, they know they need to get that win. And against another hot streak team like the Broncos, it's just going to ruin the Broncos' day. And the Texans, I believe that they can get that win. I'm not being biased in this pick, but I just think the Texans, I think they can pull up the quote-unquote upset here. So give me the Texans. Next up, you got the Carolina Panthers taking on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Panthers taking another L to the Titans last week. Not shocking. The Bucs obviously taking the L to the Colts. So two teams does not look good. But the Panthers have looked worse. They're 1-10. Bryce Young, I feel so bad for you, dude. I really do. And then the Bucks, it looks like Baker might not be healthy this week, as far as I know. I don't know. If Baker plays, I think the Bucks have the easy win here. Even if not, the Panthers, they suck. They're the worst. They're the worst in the league. I think it's undoubted? Yeah, it's undoubted that they are the worst team in the league. So give me the Bucks. Next up, you got the Cleveland Browns taking on the Los Angeles Rams. The Browns last week, they took the L last week? Yeah, they took the L to the... Who'd they lose to? Wait, what? Am I dumb? I'm so confused. Wait, they didn't lose to the Steelers, right? No, because the Steelers beat the Bengals. The Browns lost to the Broncos. That's right. That's who the Broncos beat. And then, yeah, just didn't look good last week like they have in previous weeks. But they're still 7-4. And then the Rams obviously picking up the big win against the Cardinals. Oh, my God. This is a tough pick because I want to pick upset here. I really do want to pick the upset in the Rams. Are they even the upset? Are they even the upset pick? I'm conflicted. I'm really, really conflicted. Give me the Cleveland Browns. I'm going to say that the Browns defense just comes out hot and, makes it hard for Matthew Stafford to get the ball even away. And Myles Garrett is going to ruin his day. That rhymed. Nice. So give me the Browns. Next up, you got the San Francisco 49ers taking on the Philadelphia Eagles. We got an NFC championship rematch here. Niners last week getting the big win on Thursday night, Thanksgiving, against the Seahawks. And then the Eagles obviously getting that huge win in that possible game of the year against the Bills. Which this game also could be game of the year caliber. Honestly could. See, the 49ers, obviously, they played a weakened Seahawks team last week. I know they're back to, like, complete healthiness. But in the past, they've lost those winnable games. And I think when it comes to a winning team like the Eagles, I think it's going to be difficult. And I think once again, kind of like the NFC Championship last year, I think that pass rush of the Eagles is going to make it hard for Brock Purdy. So give me the Philadelphia Eagles. I think the 49ers defense, it's good, but is it good enough to stop the best offense in the league? I don't think so, personally. So you got the best offense against the best defense, and I'm going to take the offense. I know defense wins championships. Not in my opinion, personally. And we get to the Sunday night football game. We got a big one. It'll be the Kansas City Chiefs taking on my Green Bay Packers. Chiefs last week, looked rough in the first half against the Raiders, but we're able to come back and get a big win. And then my Packers. Ooh, baby, we got a big win against the Lions. And if we beat the Lions, and the Lions beat the Chiefs, Theoretically, the Green Bay Packers should be able to pull off this win. Personally, I don't see it happening, But like every week, I can't go against my Packers. I have to take my Green Bay Packers. I think if we get pressure on Mahomes like we did last week, oh my God, the pass rush was so good. Kenny Clark, Rashawn Gary, dude. Rashawn Gary, oh my God, he is here to play and he is here to stay. And I think if he does that against Mahomes in this Chiefs team, and if our secondary with guys like Jonathan Owens, who had an amazing week last week, and Valentine, these second to third stringers who have really had to step up this year with the trade of Rasul Douglas, I think we should be able to lock down these not great receivers in Kansas City. So it's at home. It's in Lambeau. December football. I really hope it snows. Oh, I hope it snows. That'd be awesome. Give me Jordan Love. I know it hasn't been great for Jordan Love in primetime when the lights are on, but I'm going to say kicks it up a notch here and gets the big win. So give me my Packers as always. And for the Monday night football game, you have the Cincinnati Bengals taking on the Jacksonville Jaguars. The Bengals taking another L last week, down to 5-6. Not looking great for them. You know, loss of Joe Burrow has really just hit their team in the back. It really has. I mean, Jake Browning is starting to. Jake Browning. Yeah, not great, bub. Not great. And then the Jags getting the nice win against the Texans last week. Trevor Lawrence, T-Law, he's looked great this season. And see, if Burrow would be playing, I would obviously be... I don't know if it'd be obvious, but it'd be a good game. I don't see it like that anymore. It's 5-6 against 8-3. This Jags team has just looked really good this season, and I'm going to say they continue that here. So, give me T-Law in the Jacksonville Jaguars on Monday Night Football. So, yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed this video today. Got to edit this. Get it up for you guys. All that. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this video today. Please comment, like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you know when I post a new video. Bye, guys.